Welcome to your very first grade math lesson here on Seesaw and with distance learning. Here we are. Okay, to get ourselves warmed up, we are gonna count by twos. Okay, every time I count by twos, I'm gonna go like this. Count with me as far as you can. Try to stay with me, and then if you can go a little bit beyond, I'll see what you can do. You can always pause it and keep going for a sec. Here we go. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24. Can you keep going? If you want, pause it and keep counting by twos. To be able to do this activity today, you're going to need to have a whiteboard or a piece of paper near you. Make sure you have something to write with and that you're ready to pause the video at certain points so that you can write down your ideas. You can also put your ideas into the template that I've provided in Seesaw. For today's lesson, we are going to be making and organizing paper popsicles. To do that, we're gonna need to make one at the very end. You each will get to make your own and upload a picture of it onto Seesaw so we can maybe use it for an activity in the future. But let me show you the ones I'm gonna be using. I made some paper popsicles out of orange paper. Those are orange flavor. And I made some blueberry popsicles and some lime popsicles and some lemon popsicles. And I only have one grape popsicle. That one's for me. Imagine you're sitting here with me in the classroom on my circle rug, and we all just made our popsicles, and you came on over, and it's time to organize them.
Right, there's our first popsicle. What do you notice about it? Well, each one has two sticks. Now, let's see. Two more kids just came to the circle. Let me put their popsicles down. Aha! What do you notice now? Go ahead and pause the video and write down what you notice, what you see. It could be a picture, or it could be words, or you could use numbers when you write down what you notice. Oh my gosh, I just found my popsicle, so I'm gonna add it to the group. And now there's some more popsicles here. Let's see. I've got this kid's right here, and this kid's right here. What do you see now? Pause the video in just a second and write down your prediction about what is going to happen next in our pattern. Oh, here come some more kids to the circle. Let's see. Let's see if this matches your prediction or not. Let's see, this kid's goes there. This kid's goes here. This kid's goes right here. Let's see if this matches what you thought. This kid's goes right here. Pause that video and see. Does that match your prediction about what you thought was going to happen? Go ahead and draw what you see right now. Don't forget to pause so you have time to draw. Are you noticing a pattern? In the number of popsicles? Or the number of sticks? What do you see? What shape does this look like? What is going on with these popsicles in our pattern? What's gonna happen next? Let's see. Okay, the last kids just came to the group. Let's do it together. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many kids do you think are gonna be in this last row? Guess what? It's not four, it's, say it with me if you know, 5. All right, let's look at the whole pattern together. What do you see? What's going on here? What does it look like? You're going to show what you observe, what your predictions were, anything that you noticed or thought when we were creating this popsicle pattern. That's on the next page in the template. On page 1 in the student template in Seesaw, add your observations. You can use numbers or words or pictures to show what you saw in the pattern that we created in the arrangement of popsicles. The second step is to go to page 2 of the student template and arrange the popsicles I have put on the page in the same pattern I created here on the floor in the classroom.
To make your own little popsicle out of paper, you're going to need a square or rectangular piece of paper and a pencil so you can draw your shape. You're going to need some tape or glue and a pair of scissors. When you make your popsicle, you or a grown-up can draw the popsicle shape. It might be a little bit, you could use just the square bottom, or you can curve it a little bit like this and then have it come a little bit more narrow on the top. If your popsicle looks very different than this, don't worry about it. Then you're gonna cut out your popsicle shape. I like to cut on one side and then have that be the back of my popsicle. Your next step is to go ahead and use 2 popsicle sticks. If you do not have craft sticks at home, do not worry. You can do pretend craft sticks, just make them out of little pieces of paper and just have them be like your pretend popsicle sticks. What you'll do is you'll put your 2 popsicle sticks on the back, which is the side I like to do with the paper, and then you can glue or tape it on. So there's are my 2 popsicle sticks taped onto the back of my paper popsicle. Last, you're gonna go ahead and flip it over and write your name. It honestly would probably have been a better choice for me to put my name on it first. So you can do it that correct way and put your name on before you put your popsicle sticks on, or you could do it like me and just put it on at the end. Don't forget to upload a picture of your popsicle to Seesaw so that we have it in case we wanna use it for an activity soon.